coat and a pink carnation. I'm all dressed up for the dance. A white sport coat and a pink carnation. I'm all alone in romance. Once she told me long ago, to the prom with me you'd go. Now you've changed your mind, it seems. Someone else will hold my dreams. A white sport coat and a pink carnation, and in a blue, blue moon.
A white sport coat and a pink carnation.
I'm all dressed up for the dance.
A white sport coat and a pink carnation.
I'm all alone in romance. Once you told me long ago, to the prom with me you'd go. Now you've changed your mind, it seems. Someone else will hold my dreams.
A white
sport coat and a pink carnation. I'm in a blue, blue mood.
Old man Wrigley lived in that white house down the street where I grew up. Mama used to send me over with things. We struck a friendship up. Spent a few long summers out on his old porch swing. Was in the war, went in the Navy, lost his wife, lost his baby. Broke down and asked him one time, how you keep from going crazy? He said, I see my wife and son in just a little while. I asked him what he meant. He looked at me and smiled, said, I raise my hands, bow my head, finding more and more truth in the words written in red. They tell me that there's more to life than just what I can see. Oh, I believe. A few years later, I was off at college, talking to Mom on the phone one night, getting all caught up on the gossip, the ins and outs of the small town life. She said, oh, by the way, son, old man Wrigley's died. Later on that night, I laid there thinking back. Thought about a couple long lost summers. I didn't know whether to cry or laugh. If there was ever anybody deserved a ticket to the other side, it'd be that sweet old man who looked me in the eye, said I raised my hands, bow my head, finding more and more truth in the words written in red. They tell me that there's more to life than just what I could see. I can't quote the book, the chapter, or the verse. You can't tell me it all ends in a slow ride in a hearse. You know I'm more and more convinced, the longer that I live, yeah, this can't be. No, this can't be. No, this can't be all there is. Lord, I raise my hands, bow my head. Oh, I'm finding more and more truth in the words written in red. They tell me that there's more to this than just what I can see. I believe, I believe, I believe.
Superstars, organic food and foreign cars. I don't believe the price of gold, the certainty of growing old, that right is right and left is wrong, that north and south can't get along, that east is east and west is west, and being first is always best. But I believe in love, I believe in babies, I believe in mom and dad, and I believe in you. Well, I don't believe that heaven waits for only those who congregate. I like to think of God as love. He's down below, he's up above. He's watching people everywhere. He knows who does and doesn't care. And I'm an ordinary man. Sometimes I wonder who I am. But I believe in love, I believe in music, I believe in magic, and I believe in you. I know with all my certainty what's going on with you and me is a good thing. It's true, I believe in you. Thank you. I don't believe virginity is as common as it used to be. In working days and sleeping nights, that black is black and white is white, that Superman and Robin Hood are still alive in Hollywood, that gasoline's in short supply, the rising cost of getting by, but I believe in love. I believe in old folks. I believe in children. I believe in you. I believe in love. I believe in babies. I believe in mom and dad. And I believe.
Had a nightmare. You could read quite a story in the calluses and lines. Years of work and worry had left their mark behind. I remember Daddy's hand, how they held my mama tight and patted my back for something done right. There are things that I've forgotten that I loved about the man, but I'll always remember the love in Daddy's hands. Daddy's hands, soft and kind when I was crying. Daddy's hands, were hard as steel when I'd done wrong. Daddy's hands weren't always gentle, but I don't understand. There was always love in Daddy's hands. I remember Daddy's hands working till they bled, sacrificed unselfishly just to keep us all fed. If I could do things over, I'd live my life again and never take for granted the love in Daddy's hands. Daddy's hands were soft and kind when I was crying. Daddy's hands were hard as steel when I'd done wrong. Daddy's hands weren't always gentle, but I come to understand. There was always love in Daddy's hands. Daddy's hands were soft and kind when I was crying. Daddy's hands were hard as steel when I'd done wrong. Daddy's hands weren't always gentle, but I come to understand. There was always love in Daddy's hands.
Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Sometimes it feels like this world's gone crazy. Grandpa, take me back to yesterday, when the line between right and wrong didn't seem so hazy. Lovers really fall in love to stay, stand beside each other, come what may. Promise really something people can't, not just something they would say. Families really bow their heads to pray, daddies really never go away. Oh, oh, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Grandpa, everything is changing fast, we call it progress, but I just don't know. And Grandpa, let's wander back into the past, then paint me the picture of love. Lovers really fall in love to stay, stand beside each other, come what may. Promise really something people kept, not just something they would say and then forget. Families really bow their heads to pray, daddies really never go away. Oh, oh, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Oh, oh, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days. Families really bow their heads to pray, daddies really never go away.
If I had only known the last time would be the last time, I would have put off all the things I had to do. I would have stayed a little longer, held on a little tighter. Now what I'd give for one more day with you. There's a wound here in my heart where something's missing, and they tell me that it's gonna heal with time. But I know you're in a place where all your wounds have been erased, and knowing yours are healed is healing mine. The only scars in heaven, it won't be long to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now. I know the road you walked was anything but easy. You picked up your share of scars along the way. Oh, but now you're standing in the sun. You fought your fight and your race is run. The pain is all a million miles away. The only scars in heaven, it won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven, yeah, are on the hands that hold you now. Hallelujah. Now, there's not a day goes by that I don't see you. You live on in all the better parts of me. Until I'm standing with you in the sun, I'll fight this fight and this race I'll run, until I finally see what you can see. Oh, the only scars in heaven, they won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, and even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven or on the hands that hold you now? You're in a better place, I've heard a thousand times, and at least a thousand times I've rejoiced for you. But the reason why I'm broken, the reason why I cry, is how long must I wait to be with you? I close my eyes and I see your face. If home's where my heart is, then I'm out of place. Lord, won't you give me strength to make it through somehow? I've never been more homesick than I am. Help me, Lord, cause I don't understand your ways. The reason why I wonder if I'll ever know. But even if you showed me, the hurt would be the same. Cause I'm still here, so far away from home. I close my eyes and I see your face. If a home's where my heart is, then I'm out of place. Lord, won't you give me strength to make it through somehow? I've never been more homesick than now. In Christ, there are no goodbyes. And in Christ, there is no end. So I'll hold on to Jesus with all that I have. To see you again, to see you again. And I close my eyes and I see your face. If home's where my heart is.
Good morning. I want to thank everyone who has joined us this morning for this service of going home, this service of celebration of life for Victor Nelson Ledgerwood. May I invite you to stand for just a moment for our call to worship, as you are able. Jesus is speaking to Martha. And he says, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will live, even if he dies. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. You may be seated. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Our heavenly creator who gave us birth, you are ever more eager to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs and our hearts. We humbly thank you for this sweet grace and tender mercy as we face the mystery of death with the hope of life everlasting. Help us to live as those who are prepared to die, recalling always that in Christ and through Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we shall see you face to face. For this, we are ever grateful. Amen. Amen. Our first song is Dancing in the Skies.
What does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? Everything good is the same since you left. And here on earth, everything's different. There's an emptiness. Oh, I hope you're dancing in the sky. I hope you're singing in the angels' choir. And I hope the angels know what they have. I've been so nice all through heaven since you arrived. So tell me, what do you do up in heaven? All your days filled with love and light. Is there music? Is there art and invention? Tell me, are you happy? Are you more alive? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you left. And here on earth, everything's different. There's an emptiness. Oh, I hope you're dancing in the sky. And I hope you're singing in the angels' choir. And I hope the angels know what they have. I've been so nice up in heaven since you arrived. I hope you're dancing in the sky. And I hope you're singing in the angels' choir. And I hope the angels know what they have. I've been so nice up in heaven since you arrived. Since you arrived.
Thank you for whoever selected that song. That's a powerful song. It expresses beautifully that tension between letting our loved one go and the hope we have that heaven is all that Jesus has promised. Amen. Amen. Victor Nelson Ledgerwood, 86, died July 28, 2021 at Kansas Medical Center in Andover. He was born April 9, 1935, in Jefferson, Iowa, to William Nelson and Berthel Hayes Ledgerwood. Victor served in the United States Air Force from 1955 to 1958. He was a self-employed heavy equipment operator for various construction companies. One of Victor's most notable and instrumental projects was using the crane that dug the hole for the elevator at Stratica. He loved the Kansas City Chiefs and enjoyed smoking a good cigar. At age 12, Victor gave his life to Christ and he was baptized. On November 8, 1975, he married Sharon Powell Kennedy in Hutchinson. They shared almost 46 years of marriage. Victor is survived by his wife, Sharon of Hutchinson, children, Vicki Van Hoos of Hutchinson, Julie White and Steve of Wichita, Michael Ledgerwood, Sheila of Paducah, Kentucky, Jamie Martin, Mark, and Robert Kennedy, Patricia. Brother Vernil Ledgerwood, Lane of California, 12 grandchildren and numerous great-grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren. He was preceded in death by his parents, a brother Vernon, grandson James Kennedy, and son-in-law James Van Hoos. The prophet Isaiah wrote, "Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall feel exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint." Let's listen to a song about the promises of our everlasting God.
Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. You reign forever, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. You do not faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up. Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. You do not faint, you won't grow
The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of all the earth. He never grows weak or weary. No one can measure the depths of his understanding. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Even youth will become weak and tired, and young men will fall and exhaust. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They'll soar high on wings like eagles. They'll run and not grow weary. They'll walk and not faint.
In honor of Vic's service in the United States Air Force, and I like to share this poem. It reminds me also of my own father who served in the Air Force. High Flight by John Gillespie McGee. Oh, I have slipped the surly bonds of earth and danced the skies on laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I've climbed and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of, wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. Up, up the long, delirious, burning blue, I've topped the wind-swept heights with easy grace, where never lark nor ever eagle flew. And whilst with silent, lifting mind I've trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God. John 3:16-17. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. What amazing grace that is. And what an extraordinary song we'll be listening to that just describes that beautifully. Amazing grace.
Fears relieved. how precious dew that grace appear. The hour I first
Victor Nelson Ledgerwood. Vic was a free spirit, not in the higgledy-piggledy fashion of living only for himself, but in the way in which men of his sort are. That is, a man who knows what he believes and thinks and is firm in those beliefs, firm enough to speak his mind and express himself with little to no filter. I think Vic and I would have gotten along just fine. We would have understood and just had known we had to let some things slide. He was a diehard Kansas City Chiefs fan. And at the risk of revealing that I know nothing about sports, I suspect there's some hope that he has the front row seat to the Super Bowl this coming season, whenever that happens, right? He's a spoiler of grandkids, a professional mover, hard worker, self-employed, big equipment operator, business owner, give you the shirt off his back, do anything for you, but never get rid of anything. Western movie enjoyer, coin collector, Skeets customer, never met a stranger kind of guy. That's an amazing legacy, if you ask me. This is the description of the kind of man who there are too few of these days. I asked about his love for his grandkids because I remember having a grandpa who loved and adored his own grandkids. And I want to tell you, that makes a difference in a child's life to be beloved by your grandpa. To know that when you arrive at their doorstep, you are there, you are the apple of their eye. And that's what I got that sense of. But I asked, what was it that made him, that showed that love? And the answer was profound. It was evidenced in the homes he bought. They were purchased with making a friendly, comfortable, and enjoyable place for the grandkids with swimming pools and plenty of room. It makes me think of how our own Heavenly Father makes room for us in his heavenly abode. Jesus said, there is more than enough room in my Father's home. If this were not so, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? What a lovely example Sharon and Vic set in preparing a place for their loved ones in their homes. I was fascinated that one of Victor's accomplishments was digging the elevator shaft for Stratica. The project was started March 8, 2004 and was finished on March 7, 2005. That's some impressive work. I read up a little bit on that because when I read that, I thought, that's 650 feet of digging with a crane. Now, I've operated a backhoe, and I know what kind of precision work it takes to move that kind of heavy equipment. And there's not a lot of room for mistakes. He had to dig in the middle of an aquifer. That meant the aquifer had to be frozen. So they would dig. Well, they would freeze. He would dig. Then they would pour the cement. Then come back the next day and start a new section. And a new section. And a new section. 650 feet deep of that. That, my friends, is impressive. And if I've got the timeline right, that was a mere 20 years ago. Is that correct? In 2005, he did that at 69. When Vic passed from this present life into eternity, he stood in the present, 60, in the, I'm not good at math, I'm sorry. I'm terrible at math. So he stood in the presence of the Almighty God, his creator and savior, who gave him the strength and perseverance to accomplish the task of operating the crane that dug that massive shaft. I imagine Vic had an idea of how long it would take, but we don't always know such things in this world. We don't know how things are going to turn out. We don't know how long it will take for our Savior to return, but that's why we wait on the Lord. Our text from Isaiah promised that those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Those who entrust themselves to the saving power of Jesus Christ have this promise as their very own. When our bodies wear down, as they will, our limbs grow tired and weak, our eyesight grows dim, our hearing is not as strong as it will, in a moment after our last breath, we shall find ourselves on different footing. We may sleep for a little while, but for the person, it is but a moment. See, this is part of the mystery of death. We don't understand how it is that Vic, laying in repose right now, is not going to experience time the same way we will until we see him again. I would encourage each of us this day to remind ourselves that to wait on the Lord is to live in anticipation of a promise of eternal life. If you would mount up on wings as of eagles, then and be prepared to die means living in faith in Christ's promises of life everlasting, that whosoever believes in Jesus will have everlasting life, will really never die. So while today we are reminded of the stark finality of this earthly death, we turn our eyes upon the one who has conquered death and exchanged it for life. Today, consider the offer which Vic accepted when he was but a youth, 12 years old. What a remarkable life to live. And ask yourself, how might I today live the life offered me, that I may, as my eyes close the final time, mount up, be renewed in strength, and look upon the face of my Savior Jesus to worship him and live eternally as he made me to be. Amen. I'm at this time going to invite those who would like to share a personal memory of Vic up to the podium. I'm going to recommend you come up here and speak into the microphone because this is live stream and it's the way that you will be seen and the way that your voice can be picked up and heard.
few days ago, I wasn't going to do this, but last night and today, I felt like I need to. So it's correct. He's a free spirit. Everybody knows that. He had his own way of doing things, and he was 100% confident in his way of doing things. I remember as a little boy, he used to take me to work with him. And he'd let me do things that you wouldn't think he'd let me do. He was a welder. Some people don't know he was a welder. It was the first job I remember him ever having. And he used to build things from scrap, small combines and things like that. So I was at work with him one day, and he goes off to weld something. And he says, here, put this together. So I grabbed tools and started putting it together. He came back later, and it was together correctly. And he was, like, surprised. So I kind of got a sense of pride like that. But he used to take me to other stuff. He took me out when he first became a heavy equipment operator. He was operating a bulldozer one day. And he let me drive the bulldozer. And I'm telling you, I was eight, nine years old. So and it was all over the place. I messed it all up. But he knew he could fix it. Okay. But he wanted me to have that time. So, but he had lots of different jobs. He didn't want to work for anybody, so he kept going different stuff, right? He had many different jobs, many different companies. First one he had was, girls remember A&L, Abbey and Ledgerwood Construction. That one didn't work out. He had, Sharon, remember C&L Pools? A lot of people don't know. They put the first fiberglass pool installed in, I think, maybe the state of Kansas, definitely the state of Hutchinson. And it was a big newspaper article they had hanging from a crane over a house. Remember that? And he put many family members to work. Robert and I had a trip to New Mexico that we don't like to talk about anymore. some scary memories from that trip. Dad wasn't there. It was Robert and I went with Earl. We went with Earl. So Earl left us unattended too much. So we were 17. So, and I know many people in this room worked with him from time to time. As far as what's said about doing anything for anybody, there's people in this room he's done things for that needed help. There's people that are not here that he's done things for. Always willing to help somebody if they're willing to be helped themselves. And he would do anything for you. One other thing I wanted to point out, because it just occurred to me last night. Dad, he never had a suit and tie job. It's always hardworking. The clothes you saw him wear in his later days was probably similar to the clothes he used to wear to work. But when he got done with work, he prided himself in being a sharp-dressed man. So I remember that. He always, when he would come to basketball games or something like that, he was always nicely dressed. Didn't look like he was a welder or a crane operator or anything like that. He was always sharp dressed, good looking man. Girls my age, you say, oh, your daddy's so good looking. And so I heard that a lot. Some of the moms too. Anyway, in his later years, he was more interested in comfort. So he dressed comfortably. So today, as you saw, he's sharp dressed man again today. So it come around. So one other thing that just hit me when I was sitting there, when I was a boy, I always wanted to be like him. As I got older, I didn't think I was, because I had the same job for 40 years, same two jobs for 40 years. He had 40 jobs in 2 years. but then as I'm sitting here thinking about it, all the things he used to do with me and the grandkids is what I do with mine now. So today I know I am like him. So that's all I got. I got lots of.
While he is no longer here with us today, to say that he is so proud of me, I carry his strength in my heart. The kindest compliment I hope to hear someday is your grandfather would be proud of you. But one thing he never got on is every day after I get home from school, I'd walk over to Grandma Sharon's house and Grandpa Vic's, and we would play cards. He still never figured out I cheated almost every day.
He knows that.
Sorry. But some of the things that you've said today really got me thinking. Every time I saw him, he smiled and smiled and never stopped. But thank you all for joining us.
It does help. When I officiate funerals, I always figure it's a beautiful privilege to get to speak about someone who has touched so many lives. And I'll say this also. I see that legacy in Robert and Patricia Kennedy too. And I see that they're going to pass it on down because I know the Kennedy family and I know Thomas and I know Trenton and I know Brooke. And I see that evidence in them. It's a privilege to get to officiate a service in which you feel like, I wish I could have said these words about my own grandfather. I would have had I been old enough and big enough to do so. So thank you so much. Thank you for those memories that you've shared. At this time, I'm going to invite Jamie, his daughter, to come and sing a song.
His strength is
we can only know the power that he holds when we truly see how deep our weakness goes. His strength in us begins.
I invite you to bow your heads and pray with me the prayer that Jesus gave to his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. I invite you to stand for the benediction. Following the service, we will be, the committal will take place at Memorial Gardens on 4th Street. Now, to him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you before his glorious presence without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
And they tell me that it's gonna heal the time. But I know you're in a place where all your wounds have been erased. And knowing yours are healed is healing mine. The only scars in heaven that won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now. I know the road you walked was anything but easy. You picked up your share of scars along the way. Oh, but now you're standing in the sun. You fought your fight and your race is run. The pain is all a million miles away. The only scars in heaven, they won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven, yeah, are on the hands that hold you now. How